Let's have some fun. Welcome back. If you're new, my name is Shane, and I am sharing some of my favorite songs on my Spotify playlist. In addition to that, some of my favorite YouTube music videos. But I also do requests, and this is actually a request to listen to Queen's performance at Live Aid in 1985. Obviously, I do know who Queen is. I've heard a lot of probably most of the Queen songs. I have seen bits and pieces of this performance, but I've not seen the whole thing in its entirety. So yeah, I'm really excited to check it out in its entirety. I know that this is considered one of the best live performances of all time, so definitely interested in seeing that. I know Freddie Mercury is just an incredible performer, incredible singer, and so yeah, really excited to check this out and see how it is. So yeah, let's have a listen.
Ladies and gentlemen, could we have a very warm Wembley welcome, please, for Mel Smith and Griff Rhys-Jones.
A little warm up here.
One, two. One, two. One, two. Yeah, I know what Paul is too. Constable, thank you very much.
This is our spare lead vocal mic.
Constable.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but we have had a bit of a complaint about the noise.
Wow. Wow.
From a woman in Belgium.
Ladies and gentlemen, obviously, boys and girls, we're enjoying the boogie-woogie music here today. But I would ask you to bear in mind that there are a lot of people, perhaps older people, in the area who perhaps aren't up to date with the latest trends in modern music. Like Status Quo, for example.
Wow, that's a lot of people.
Anyway, it gives us enormous pleasure to introduce the next combo, who are... Her Majesty, Queen!
To make you cry.
So just some first comments here. They come out with a, you know, with a great song, of course. Crowd favorite, I'm sure. I was wondering, I know that it's only, what, 23 minutes. So they, you know, this song alone would be, would eat up a lot of that time. So I didn't figure they were going to do the whole thing. I also noticed on the piano, there's a lot of like, well, Pepsi cups and beer and that kind of thing. And if they just came out, I wonder whose drinks those are. I mean, I know that there were acts prior to this, don't get me wrong, but was the prior band using the piano? And I don't know. Be curious to know that. Yeah, let's listen to some more. Let's see what song they do next. So many people. Of course, he has his signature mini mic stand there. How many people were here? It looks like a lot of people. I mean, obviously not just the stadium itself where the seating would be, but all, they just said general area. Wonder how many people. I don't think I know how many people were here. It's got to be a lot of people. And to have that many in unison, man, as a performer, that has just got to really energize you for sure. Yeah. Curious to see what they do next. Oh, okay. Yeah. I have heard this part. Great vocal control. Great vocal control. Playing to the camera. Time for the hammer to fall. all those numbers. Okay, well, he's drinking. Maybe he put all those there. I don't know. Okay. Crazy little thing called love.
This next song is only dedicated to beautiful people here tonight.
So I'll try not to pause it again here. Yeah, I saw him take a drink out of one of those glasses. So that maybe they did put those there in anticipation. Good question. Well, seeing him don a guitar, I know he wasn't known as a guitar player, but I know he did play in Crazy Little Thing Called Love. So that makes me think that's what song is next. I know.
It means all of you. Thank you for coming along. And making this a great occasion.
Yep.
Crazy little
performance. Assuming this is the last song.
Buddy, you're a boy, make a big noise, playing in the street. Gotta be a big man someday. A matter on your face, big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place. See? Yeah, do it! I like it. Sing it again!
Wow. Whoa. Yeah, I remember Live Aid when I was younger. I don't remember if I watched any of it back then. As I said, I've seen bits and pieces of this, but it's really incredible just to see it, the full set in its entirety. The things that kind of stand out are, yeah, they did a couple of their top hits, but it wasn't just back-to-back top hits the whole time by any means. Wow, yeah, he is just such a performer, an amazing performer for sure. Great vocalist, as I said before. And just seeing the set, yeah. Just the way he interacted with the crowd, it got them into it. Just incredible. This is a really great set for sure. If I was to think about whether this is the best live performance of all time I've seen, it was really good. I don't know if it'd be the best live performance I've seen, but it was incredible, don't get me wrong. And just the number of people there was just insane. And this how much entertainment they packed into those 23 minutes is incredible also. So I don't know. What do you guys think? Is it your favorite live performance? Are there other live performances that you think are better than this in terms of like a set? Do you remember Live Aid? Were you alive back then? I remember it was around the same time that they had, We Are the World and what's the name of the other song? Let Them Know It's Christmas. Probably getting that song title wrong, but it's all about the same time. And it's funny, I don't hear too many people talk about other artists during this concert. So, I mean, there were other top artists, obviously, that were in this concert. So I'm wondering why they don't have anything about their sets. Was this that much better live than the other performers? I don't know. And as I said, I'm really curious to know how many people were there, because it looked crazy. Anyway, hope you enjoyed it. I know it's a little longer than most videos that I posted. It's 23 minutes, so hope you enjoyed it anyway. And let me know what you think. This is the kind of content that you like. Feel free to subscribe. And until next time, have a great evening.